I brought gold, too. 8th grade class at Friends Select. My name is Desiree Harmon, and I am pleased to be the director of the middle school here at Friends Select. I want to begin today by saying to the middle school faculty and staff, this year has been more than challenging in so many ways, yet at every step of the way, you have gone above and beyond to ensure that our students were learning and receiving what they needed. Please stand so we can celebrate the middle school faculty and staff. Thank you. I would also like to give a very special shout out to Chris Kottkamp, who was our middle school administrative assistant. Chris is so gracious and humble. She is truly the backbone of the middle school. She keeps many of the moving parts going, and we all thank you. We have this beautiful bouquet of flowers for you, Chris. When we started thinking of how we could have an eighth grade moving up ceremony during a pandemic, we knew a committee of advisors, parents, and students would be the best way to go. Please join me in thanking our parent volunteers, Jamie Cohen, Valerie Brand Papano, Carolyn Semmel, and Annette Warner. Our very special eighth grade advisors, Teacher Andrew, Teacher Eric, and Teacher Dan. And our eighth graders on the committee, Nora, Claire, and Leela, who also designed the class sweatshirt and the mask. Now, to my eighth graders. In-school learning, all virtual learning, hybrid learning, social distancing, and hand sanitizer with masks. This has been the total of your eighth grade year. Nevertheless, you made it here to this moment, finishing out your middle school experience and preparing for your next big journey, upper school. I know at various times in your life, you've heard your parents or other members of your family say, take your time and enjoy being a kid. Your childhood passes by far too quickly. Having lived through the past 15 months in a pandemic, I know these statements might sound like a falsehood, more gibberish your parents say to justify why they are telling you no, or putting limits on some activity that in you and your friend's mind sounded incredible. I am here to tell you that these words are not gibberish. They are spoken with the utmost love and respect for you, because you are your parents' most precious commodity. They want you to enjoy the moment. Please take it in for all it's worth, the good and the bad. The pandemic served us a big platter of enjoying the moment, because things can change just like that, and they did big time. This time last spring, we were all shuttering in our homes, teaching and learning as best as we could in our kitchens, living rooms, and bedrooms. You all graciously finished out your seventh grade year and started eighth grade in uncertainty. We were all swimming in a pool of the unknown. You started the school year in hybrid mode, switched to learning at home, and then transitioned back into learning in the building. Not to mention, we lived through five different schedules this year. You all took it all in stride and managed to find creative ways to remain connected to your peers. COVID touched us all, and for some of us, it left an indelible mark, taking away our loved ones and family members. This pandemic will not be forgotten by many of us. Not for all the bad that it brought, but for the good parts of humankind that were showcased to give us hope and something to look forward to. This year has not been easy for us, however, you made it. You managed it all while learning Mandarin, Latin, or Spanish, learning about the social justice implications of green space and redlining in human geography, learning about the effect and impact of global warming on our world, and learning algebra and geometry, while reading a few books too. The middle school at Friends Select has been your place, the place where you were known, valued, and became your best self in academics, art, and athletics. With the support of your teachers, you have learned how to become independent, advocate for yourself, and you have begun to find your place in the larger world outside of Friends Select. Was it easy? No. Were there obstacles along the way? Yes. Was it worth it? Absolutely. Congratulations, eighth graders. Your families are proud of you. Your teachers are proud of you. I am proud of you. And most importantly, you should be proud of yourself. It is now my pleasure to welcome Michael Gary, the head of Friends Select School, to say a few words to our eighth graders.
Thank you, Des. Before I say a few words of congratulations to our eighth graders, I'm going to say a few words of congratulations to the community, starting with you parents. I'm a firm believer that education starts in the home, and that we would not have a school if you did not share your awesome responsibility of educating your young scholars with us. So thank you for sharing it with us, and congratulations to you for getting through this year. Teachers, faculty, congratulations to you. I'll tell you, back in August, when we all was trying to navigate whether we're gonna come in person, go virtual, it was unbelievably daunting to your head of school. There's no playbook for running a school during the pandemic, but you showed up with joy, and you continue to show up with joy because you know the center of education is none other than the young people right here. So congratulations to you for getting through this moment. And eighth graders, congratulations to you for navigating a period of time along with we adults who had no idea of how to drive the car, the school, the work, you name it. But thank you for being patient. Thank you for being nimble. And thank you for relying on us as your community. So my words to you are these. Remember being nimble, remember being patient, and remember to find your community in times of great uncertainty. That's what we were successful in navigating. If my chest is out here, it's because the finish line is right there. And when you're a track runner, you stick your chest out to get across that line before the other people. My chest is out because the finish line is so close. It's today. And we're here at the finish line because we were nimble. Teacher Des, it was 5 different schedules that you had to navigate. That's a lifelong skill to be nimble. Be patient. Be patient with yourself. Please be patient with your parents. Be patient with your siblings. It's a great character trait to have. Be patient. And last, and certainly not least, and this is the hallmark of our school, being in community. Because not one person has all the answer. Not one person has all the answers. There's some of you in the audience know how many times I pulled on your sleeves, early morning video calls. You've been extremely helpful to this head of school in navigating what was the most challenging year of all. Find your community. It may be a neighbor, it may be a teammate, it may be all of you are gonna stay together moving up, but if not, find your community and work with them, rely on them, confide in them, trust in them, and know that not any one person has all the answers, but there's room and there's space for someone to add to whatever knowledge you have. Collectively, congratulations to everyone in this room, but more importantly to you all, young people, young scholars, for getting to the finish line. Congratulations.
We will now hear from our student speakers. Our first speaker is Jackson Adams, reading about the roof, followed by Emily Kessler with her speech titled Friends and Memories.
It was a nice warm day on the Friends Select roof, with the wind blowing in my face and the sound of cars down on the street. I had just come up from the cafeteria with the taste of lemonade still on my mouth. I had also taken Timberlands to school that day instead of sneakers, so I decided to take them and run around in socks. While I was up on the roof, I noticed how crowded and tight it was, with most of everyone in middle school enjoying the weather. We had just started playing an aggressive game of wiffle ball with the whole grade. We really never kept track of the score, but the game was still competitive somehow. Since the roof was packed, when the tennis ball was hit to the other corner of the roof, it was really hard not to run into anyone while chasing the ball. This made the game more active, energetic for everyone, whether it was cheering your teammate on, running to get the tennis ball, or sprinting around the bases. The game progressed on with both teams scoring one after another, until during one inning, a pop fly was hit to center field, and no one was there. So I followed my natural instinct to go after the tennis ball and catch it. Little did I know, a fifth grade football game was going on just to the left of me in center field. I took one look to check my surroundings and sprinted full speed towards the ball. I was halfway to the ball and I was picturing myself catching the object, but it never happened because bam, collision. The next thing I knew, I woke up on the ground with turf and sweat all over my face. At first, I didn't know who I ran into on the roof, but later on, I learned his name was Ben, a fifth grader at the time I knew. My vision was obscured, but I could make out the image of a ring of people standing around me. I was surrounded by a circle of warmth and protection. It was my community that I sensed around me. In the hospital, all the strong antibiotic smells and the cold air was something I had to get used to, since I always walk around my house with a hoodie or sweatshirt on. I remember I wasn't allowed to get out of bed for certain medical reasons for about a week. I also think back to the experience of the hospital room being very boring until I started learning about facial muscles and ear muscles. I occupied my other time with drawing as much as I could, watching TV, English from teacher Danco, and a math packet from teacher Patrick. During the 2 weeks I was in the hospital, teacher Michael and his wife visited me in the hospital and occupied me. Teacher Jez visited me as well and brought me Starbucks to lift my mom's spirits. And my very good friend Ross stopped by and we played a Family Feud card game. I was given very kind gifts from my friends and family members who lived in other parts of the country. But the one gift that really put a smile on my face was the large oversized card given to me by all my classmates and teachers. Reading all those notes and just seeing the signatures really showed me the true bond I had with my classmates, as well as loyalty and nurturing spirits they all have. It was a community, my community. Coming up with only one word or phrase to describe the accident was very tough for me because all the emotions that I went through. But if I had to choose a phrase, it would be life-changing. I believe the whole mishap obviously wasn't a good thing, but the process from start to finish was with recovering back to normal really shows the patience, determination, and positive mindset overall. Every now and then, I see the roof as an obstruction, as well as every time I set foot in the same corner the incident happened. But at the same time, I remind myself to keep my head high and live my life one step at a time. Thank you.
On the first day of preschool, when I was crying, sitting at a table because my mom had just left, Kate, being the social butterfly she is, came over to me and asked if I wanted to play with dolls. Yep, this relationship started with me crying and playing with dolls. While we were playing with dolls, I wondered why Kate was not upset over her parents leaving. I assumed she was weird, and over the time, I realized how right I was. Hi, everybody. My name is Emily, and my pronouns are he, they, she. This story of how Kate and I met means so much to me because over the years, I've met so many friends, all because of this one day. Over the years of being friends with Kate, she has taught me to be more open. Our grade has always welcomed people who are new, and I hope this skill only gets better as time moves on. Kate also helped me feel welcomed. This helped me through that one day so much, and she has never stopped doing that. She has constantly been there for me, and I only hope to bring a fraction of that with me. Something that is amazing about our community is that if someone is struggling either academically, mentally, and/or physically, there's always someone there to help. Well, in the sense of all of that, and not when someone's stuck in a tree and needs help getting down, but I digress. I have been here for 10 years, and I've made so many friends here, and I have shared amazing memories, and I would like to say thank you for that. This grade has become such a big part of my life, and I'm so sad to have this part be over. Some of my favorite memories from my 10 years here that I would like to share with all of you are being in extra time for standardized testing and having all the mints in the world, and someone bringing in like 400 pencils to make sure we had enough. Being huddled around a lunch table, laughing and talking, and usually making fun in a loving way of Kate or Ella. Most of my friends looking over Lila's and mine paper to make sure we didn't spell anything wrong or have any grammatical errors, like Ella did for this. Our grade playing wall ball, football, tennis racket, baseball, and soccer. Well, until we got them banned, at least. Having placemats we could customize in kindergarten, taking our jobs, well, just for line leader and door holder, super seriously, and door holder having to sprint to get to the front of the line to get to the next door. Fifth grade's first lunch, when the whole cafeteria was open and everyone was so excited. Chocolate milk days and ice cream days in lower school, and the best part being when something would happen and they would move ice cream day to chocolate milk day or chocolate milk day to ice cream day, and oh boy, were those last few classes a treat. Late night tests asking, wait, did we have math homework? And the answer always being yes, and it's due tomorrow. Ella in eighth grade without fail always mentioning how short I was. All of these memories have shaped me into the person I am today. Like I said before, I have been here for 10 years, and that is a long time. Over the years, I've watched people leave, and I always said that would never be me. Well, past me, I have some bad news. Even though I won't be here next year, there is no doubt in my mind that everyone here will do great. Although this year has been whack, everyone here has put in so much effort to be here. And this is something we should all be proud of. Unless you're Ella, and peanuts can take you out like you're nothing. But we survived a global pandemic and still got passing grades. To graduate and even diagram pointless sentences in English, I mean, come on, not a lot of people can say that. Thank you so much, eighth grade, for these lovely 10 years. Thank you so much to all my teachers from pre-K to today for getting me to this point. And finally, thank you so much to my family who has never stopped looking out for me. I can't wait to see what happens in high school, and I know it will all work out in the end.
We will now hear from our next two speakers, What Goes Unsaid by Lena Piven and Coming to Friends Select by Sage Matunda.
What Goes Unsaid. Welcome friends, family, teachers, and especially my fellow classmates. If you don't know me, I'm Lena Piven, and I've been here since kindergarten, so I've had the pleasure of watching these impressive, fun, intelligent, inclusive, and caring group of students grow. As a group and individuals, our grade has come a long way to get here today, on this beautiful day. First of all, I'd like to congratulate my peers in accomplishing the past 4 years of middle school, putting in an extreme amount of effort. Everyone standing here behind me has survived 4 years of competitive capture the flag, people interacting with the environment statements, sentence diagramming, geography test, seventh grade math warm-ups, and more. There were many times when I believed that I wasn't going to be able to reach the finish line. I'm sure everyone here has felt this way at one point or another. But those extreme amount of struggles and disappointments have only made this day sweeter. Today, I stand here before you intending to speak on the growth of the grade as a whole. Instead, I find myself having the urge to speak on my struggles, massive difficulties, accomplishments, and well-being. So here are a few poems that I wrote speaking on what you may find heavy topics. Here are two poems I have written called Recently. You okay? How was your day? Fine, I say over and over again. I would never say no. I was never able to tell myself and you the truth. Yet here I am today. I had no reason to not be fine. I have everything, don't I? My parents are together. I go to private school. My grades are where I want them. What else could I ask for? I smile big day after day. I'm quite sure it's convincing. Even when my eyes are tearing up, blocking my vision, I respond with, I'm fine. Because would I ever have a valid reason that they would understand? Am I really all alone? I look around and see everyone has found their person, their own sense of happiness and worth. It looks like I am once again all alone. But then again, I have everything and everybody. Is it really fair for me to feel this way, all alone? After this sense of isolation, some of you may have felt as well, especially during the past year or so, which is what I was attempting to get at in my poems. And I'm hoping that these poems show you that you're never really alone. In closing, this grade has grown, overcome, and made memories, even this year when we felt especially separated. Looking back at this year, I was trying to look at the positives, like dancing along with Just Dance and everyone from other advisories joining in, or when we were all finding ways to communicate and feel a sense of community or friendship while playing online games with one another after school. Thank you to all the teachers I have had these past 4 years. I especially want to give a shout out to Teacher Anne, who I've had since fifth grade, and Teacher Zatoya, who I've only had for this year. Thank you for teaching and helping me in my academic life, but also changing the way I view life. I also want to thank my friends, the people who I've known since kindergarten, and the people I've met, and the people I've just met and gotten much closer to this year, even under the circumstances. Have a great summer.
Coming to Friends Select. As many of y'all know, I joined Friends Select in sixth grade. Before that, I attended a school in New York from kindergarten to fourth grade, then switched to a temporary school near my grandparents while moving to Philadelphia to then attend Friends Select. It was very difficult leaving New York because those were the friends I grew up with, but over time I was able to overcome this and move on while staying in close contact with the friends that were close. Since I went to a temporary school for a year before coming here, I wasn't able to settle in and the year just blew by, really not being able to become close with anyone. Coming to Friends Select for sixth grade and knowing I was gonna stay for much longer was a relief, but I was still a bit nervous about what it would be like to join a new school that was a private school with many different rules. Joining Friends Select was hard at first, not knowing anyone, and starting new, I had many questions, like would the food be good? How would it be in a Quaker school? How would this experience be? For the first few weeks, it was hard getting used to it, but after some time, I felt like I settled in. The first few days were weird because of the different rules and the type of schedule that I had to get used to, but over time, it became second nature to me. At my old school, we had a much smaller building, longer days at school, and didn't have any school sports. I heard that Friends Select had shorter days because of they had sports after school. I was relieved when I heard this because I always liked doing sports with my friends in New York. The only people I knew when coming to Friends Select were Ross and Jackson, because they were the ones who showed me around school when I visited. One thing that helped me a lot was doing sports. Sports helped me get to know people out of my grade and teachers. Carl was the first teacher that I properly met because I did soccer. It was the start of middle school. That doesn't sound like much now, but then it was a lot for me because of everything happening at the time. For the first few weeks, it was challenging trying to get used to learning the new style. Things were done much differently than I was used to, but after some time, it just became normal. We've learned a lot of navigating being a middle school student, and these skills are about to become important to us again as we move up to upper school. For those of us who will be staying at Friends Select, we can do a lot of these things to make our up-and-coming new Friends Select students feel like a part of our community. And for those of us leaving Friends Select, I hope you settle in nicely and have great experience at your new school. Coming to Friends Select was not difficult as I thought it would be. I was able to make friends easily, making my experiences as a new student fairly easy when trying to settle in. Thank you.
We will now hear from our last two student speakers, Always Another Door by Kate Gunther and The Courage to Write a Speech by Shelby Allen.
There's always an unspoken truth that we all must face. Whether we want to or not, everything ends. It's one of those sayings I would hate when people would say. Why focus on that negative? So as much as I've looked forward to this milestone, I've always disliked endings. The last minute of a new movie, the last day of summer, but these things are inevitable. Today, we say goodbye to everything that has been comfortable and familiar for these past 4 years. But just because this chapter's closing doesn't mean we lose people. We will always have people in our lives that will never truly leave us. A grandparent, a friend, a cousin, anyone. They're always there. And those people to me are my classmates sitting behind me. We're all living through something historical, COVID, that hasn't been easy. We've all felt alone. We've all felt scared, trying to stay connected to our families, to our old daily lives. Still, what really matters is how we come out of it. We come out stronger, as both individuals and as a team. And that is my grade. For some of us, that's been 10 glorious years. And I'd say those years were worth it. From playing kickball and wall ball on the roof, from second grade plays and yearly picnics, our lower school years were a time to be joyous little kids. From weekly clubs to essays, from birthday parties and b'nai mitzvahs to our first team sports, our middle school years have been a time to be independent. Now, don't get me wrong, we weren't always that in control. From getting sports banned on the roof, well, I'll stop there. We really are an interesting bunch of kids. Now, I know pre-K me would be shocked and scared with how our world is now. Not only this virus we're all facing, but all of our problems. Issues that our generation will have to work to overcome. Climate change, gun control, and dealing with more illnesses and diseases like cancer will be our generation's problem. All of these are killing us and our planet. Whenever I've been to CHOP over the years, I would always walk through the cancer ward, and I'd see little kids preparing to go to chemotherapy, unaware of how upsetting their state of being was. With climate change, every year, we add more species to our extinct and endangered lists as their habitats are taken away from them. And climate change and gun control. Not every school is as lucky with their protection to save everyone. This is the world we live in. The tooth fairy may not come anymore. We may not play with our food anymore. And we may not get stuck in trees calling for a friend. Well, unless you're Emily. We may fight with our parents more over our schedules and not over how much broccoli we have to eat. We may not run around with our shirts inside out, and we may not run around bothering our parents who are working from home. Well, I still might. Sorry, Dad. And that's because we're older, stronger, and more knowledgeable. We're able to see around more corners and understand that there's a large amount of truth to sayings like, don't grow up too quickly, or think before you speak. Our eyes are open now to global issues and the little things that our younger selves took for granted. All I can say is I actually miss nap time. This is one step of many, We can all check middle school off our lists. So what's left? Being able to drive? Yeah, that'll be interesting. Being able to choose our own favorite classes? Being able to drive? Being able to vote? We'll all have the opportunities to be a part of how this world develops in one way or another. And as with time, we'll grow up in different ways and all face the joys adult life can give us. We're all here because someone in our lives have made sacrifices. We are able to have an education not available to all. So thank your families for supporting you every step of the way. Thank you, teachers, for your passion and devotion that has helped us to realize that being first in line isn't a life or death situation. Thank you, faculty, for helping to make this building the beautiful space it is. And lastly, thank you, siblings, pets, or other family members that always make us laugh, always. So everything comes to an end. It's one of those things I would hate when people would say, why focus on that negative? But what I never realized was all they were saying was to be grateful and remember that there's always another door that needs to be open. Thank you.
Hello, FFS community, students, teachers, parents, faculty, and friends. Today is a special day. It's graduation day, a day full of excitement, glee, and even some nervousness. Or maybe all three, but look on the bright side. We made it. Thanks to our teachers and advisors' hard work this year, all those tests, assignments, and projects, the ones you worked day and night on, and the ones we may have forgotten until last minute. Like this speech. To the graduates today, no matter how small or unimportant you thought those tasks were, all your hard work has led you to this moment. And maybe there was a class you could have done better in if only you had the courage to raise your hand and ask more questions. Or maybe there was some opportunities you didn't take the risks because you were scared of how you'd look. I'm here to say, step out of your box and take a risk because those risks are worth taking. Now, you may be wondering, who is she? And honestly, if I was in the audience at this moment, I'd be thinking the same. Hi again, my name is Shelby Allen. I'm an eighth grader and I came to FFSS in grade 7. Though I'd like to say in the years that I've spent here, I've changed quite a bit. When I first arrived, I was 12, shy, and scared of all social interactions. But now, I'm 14, shy, 2 inches taller, and only scared of most social interactions. It may be small, but it's still something. And you might be asking yourself, wow, I wonder how she got the courage to write this speech if she was so shy. And if you did ask yourself that, then I have the answer for you. I don't really know. But I think it starts with a very awkward drive home. It was a regular afternoon drive home from school. Like usual, I had my head against the window. Music was playing, and me and my dad were making idle chit-chat until, horrifyingly, he asked the worst question imaginable.
Shelby, how was your day at school today?
Oh no, I said. Good, while silently praying this topic would end there. And I thought it did, but then my dad said, why? Why was it good? Oh no, I thought. If only he knew what really happened. But what really happened? My hands clammed up. My heart rate reached unknown and concerning speeds. I was sure I was going to melt into a thick stain in the car for my dad to try and clean up later. But what actually happened? Well, I missed an assignment today. There was a hard test that I'm sure I failed. I didn't get to eat breakfast. I almost cried in science class. I'm pretty sure there was a stain on my pants and everyone saw it, but nobody said anything. And as I racked my smooth brain for any reason this day would classify as good, I couldn't find anything. So instead of saying all this, you know, like somebody would, I kept it to myself and simply replied, because it was. And we continued driving. And it went on like this for several weeks. Until one day, I thought to myself, things have to change. And so I walked into school that day with this mindset. And guess what? I had a bad day. But I made the choice to talk to someone new. And the next day, I chose to hang out with a group of classmates. And the next day, I started to play sports on the roof. And the next day, I just played Just Dance at 8 a.m. in the morning in class. And one day, after all that time, I said, yeah, I should write a speech. And so, to answer the question, that's how I gained the courage to write this speech. Whenever I have a bad day, I think back to that time. And I remember all the amazing things I experienced because I decided to step out of my comfort zone. And I learned that sometimes one obstacle that you have to overcome can be yourself. So I leave you with this one thought. As we look forward to going to high school, here's one quote by Maya Angelou. If you don't like something, change it. And if you can't change it, change your attitude. So, an extra, extra thank you to all of my teachers over the past 2 years. Teacher Alexis, Teacher Danco, Teacher Andrew, Teacher Mike, Teacher Dan, Teacher Danielle, Teacher Fred, Teacher Krista, Teacher Satoya, and Teacher Eric. And to the amazing faculty that kept us safe during the pandemic. And a final thank you to everybody in my grade. Emily, Ben, Daphne, Rachel, Lena, Ella, Kate, Nora, Jackson, Tibor, Oren, Will, Jordan, Olivia, Dante, Sage, this might take a while, Daniel, Elijah, Coyote, Kylie, Hallie, Sam, Claire, Dylan, Ptolemy, Ross, Avery, Isaiah, Paloma, Maddie, and Cole. If I forgot anybody, I'm very sorry. And an extra, 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 extra thank you, this is the last one, to my cool family, my mom, my dad, sister Imani, brother Michael, my aunt, and my awesome grandmas. Thank you, everybody. Have a nice summer.
And this is why I love what I do. I love my eighth graders. I love my middle schoolers. We are now going to have a song, River Flows in You by Yurima, performed by Olo Coyote Ekindare, followed by Meeting for Worship Introductions by Dan Capecchi. Thank you.
Thank you, Coyote, and to all our student speakers. We will soon begin meeting for worship. A central tenet of the Quaker faith is that there is that of God, a light in each of us. Quakers gather to still themselves in silence with the expectation that if each of us listens to that light, that we are capable of realizations and revelations that might not only lead us to live more centered, just, and peaceful lives, but when shared, can lift our community to do the same. If you haven't done so already, please silent or turn off your cell phones. If we were in the meeting house, and if you felt moved to speak, we would ask that you would stand as you're able and speak clearly to share your message. Here in the gymnasium and with masks on, it will be more difficult to hear each other. So we have some wonderful seventh graders who are here to help assist us. They will be with microphones around the gym. And if you could raise your hand, they will bring a mic out to you. Although I have to acknowledge that as I look out, I don't see our wonderful seventh graders. Oh, great, they're sitting. Okay, cool, they're waving. They're just waiting to get in position. Whew. Good job, guys, thank you. So, if from the silence you feel moved to share a message, please rise or raise your hand and we'll get a mic to you. Please speak clearly so that we can all hear. And let us all please allow for a few moments of silence between messages so that they can resonate with us as a group. Meeting for worship will end with some fist bumps and waves of gratification. Let's now settle into silence together for our worship.
Hi, good morning, everyone. I have watched you guys say some incredible words that I think as parents, we too can be inspired by. I am, oh, hi, everybody. I'm Shelby's mom. I was just sitting here and thinking about some words that an incredible mentor had said to me. Her name is Dr. Kariyama Welsh. And she once told me, she said, "You never fully appreciate history when you're living it." And I could not imagine what it could be like to go through eighth grade during a pandemic. So I applaud all of you faculty. I mean, I'm in academia myself and faculty. I mean, this has been an incredible challenge. And I just want to say thank you so much for taking care of our children. I could only imagine shifting assignments and making adjustments. And you guys have allowed for them to be able to, you know, find their way through this and to also give us some sense of guidance. And so I appreciate all the late nights that you stood up thinking about our kids. To all of the administration, thank you for just, you know, being able to get through something that, I mean, was extremely tough on not just, you know, here in Philadelphia, but we're talking about around the world, and you guys have like navigated through all of this and tried to keep us on top of it as well. So I just want to say thank you. And to you guys, I don't know what memories that you guys are going to pull from this moment, but just know that you guys are living history and that everything that you did this year, realize that you can look back on it and know that you got through this. And to be honest, a lot of adults, it was difficult on us as well. And you guys seem to kind of take it with stride and to really be able to get to this moment and find a way to be able to kind of keep each other up. So I just wanted to say thank you to everyone. And I'm really appreciative of being here at this moment, living history.
Hello? I didn't know if y'all could hear me or not. I'm sorry. I'll come right there in the center so everybody don't have to turn their head. I'm sorry. First off, I want to say good morning to everybody and congratulations to all y'all eighth graders who graduated today. I'm Isaiah Marshall, older brother. Isaiah, can you stand up so they know who you are? Thank you. I'm Isaiah, older brother. And we came here today and I just wanted to say I'm proud of you, bro. How you handled all your responsibilities. You did, it was hard for him, you know, because he had AAU practice. He's the only eighth grader on the basketball team. And he was just coming to practice, training every day. So I want to say, I'm proud of you. And I don't know all of the children, but I'm proud of all y'all because like the woman before me said, it's hard going to school in the pandemic. It's hard wearing a mask every day. It's hard being able to focus. It's hard doing school online. Because Lord knows I couldn't get through my school online. And I'm in college, so it's hard. And y'all should give yourself a round of applause and be happy that y'all got through this because not every day history is made like this. And I just wanted to say, Isaiah, keep doing what you're doing, kid. I'm proud of you. I'm happy to call you my little brother. You're one of a kind. You're special. You're talented. And I appreciate all the things that you did for me, the things you do for me. And also, for the children as well, make sure you say thank you to your parents because your parents, this was hard on your parents and as well as the staff over there, you know, because this wasn't easy. And y'all should be very proud of yourself. And like, I also want to say thank you to the staff as well, because y'all handled my little brother with care, and I'm pretty sure I handled all the other students the same as well. I really appreciate that, because I know it's not easy on y'all driving and catching Ubers or even catching a bus to work every day and coming here wearing a mask and having to deal with a lot of different personalities, because I work with kids myself, so I know how stressful that can be. So I just want to say, thank you. And I'm sorry, am I talking too much? I'm sorry. Thank you. Thank you, but I'm done. Thank you.
Hey, good morning, everybody. I'm Teacher Jay, one of the support staff teachers here. It's been one heck of a year. It's been one heck of a year. I was in a teacher's assistant who came in to provide break rotations for the students. As you know, they stayed in classroom as teachers moved to different classrooms to facilitate the classes. So I was one of the support teachers that made sure they got outside, got some fresh air, got to stretch their legs and arms and just take a break from being inside the classroom. And when I understood the gravity of the situation in our education system with this pandemic happening, and I was already employed with Friends Select family years ago. So I came back when I heard there was a need, and I wasn't sure how all this would work, all this would play out, how would it would affect the students, how would it affect the faculty, how would it would affect me. And I really have a renewed sense of strength and hope seeing how things were handled this year. The intelligence that your children possess is far greater than what I had when I was that age. Trying to handle a situation like this, the maturity level, the respect and love for one another. It was truly amazing to see. I enjoyed every minute, the conversations we had, the jokes we shared, the trials and tribulations that folks went through that we had to take time out just to talk about and figure out how we could get through this. This was an amazing year. I thank all the faculty here, definitely all the eighth graders. You have impressed me. You have locked a very strong place in my heart for what you do and what you've done this year. And I want to commend everyone who was a part of this experience. It was amazing. It was a tough year, and we got through it, I believe, with flying colors. So I just wanted to say thank you to the eighth grade, the faculty, and the FSS community as a whole. I appreciate you all. This really helped renew my sense of hope in education in general and for the future. and our appreciation. I'm very happy to be a part of this year and this experience in your lives. So thank you all.
Good morning. I'm Michael Reese. Sage is my grandson. And when the pandemic struck, my wife and I were returning from the winter in Florida, and we got quarantined by our children very quickly. And our children all worked, and Sage and his sister Ona were both, Ona was in preschool and Sage was Friend Select. So I live out in Bucks County, so we moved Sage and Ona, his sister, out to our home in the fall, and they went by Zoom to school. And I just see this as such a blessing in my life and in my wife's life. And I was so excited. Every morning, Sage would be up, 8 o'clock, laptop going, in school. I'd peek in every once in a while, paying attention. And my daughter, my granddaughter, Ona, was in preschool, which is also Zoom. So I got to learn how to use Zoom and passwords, which sometimes didn't work all the time. And it wasn't because of me. And I was happy for that too, because I thought, geez, other people have problems with Zoom. And all I can say is the pandemic was, it cut both ways. I got to spend more quality time with my grandchildren than I probably ever would have under normal circumstances. I got to go to preschool. I'm 75 years old. I never had so much fun, I don't think, in the last 20 years. I got introduced to children's books that just blew me away. And my mom and dad had all the golden books for me that were in print in those years. And boy, oh boy, have books really gotten good. And really, if you haven't read a good children's book for a while, pick one up and read it. The Giving Tree. Books of that nature, just such quality. And the one thing I've noticed going to various functions at Friends Select is what a beautiful place this is. This is an oasis. And we're fortunate. Our children, our grandchildren are in an oasis. And they're being taught. They're being taught principles. They're being taught character. And that's not easy to come by today. So I just want to thank the faculty. Those of you that I've met over the years, you're just the best. You really are. The administrators, you run a good ship. This is a good place. This is a good place to park your kids. For as long as you park them here, you're not going to go wrong. So just thank you. And to the students, hey, you did it. You did something that you'll talk about in 50 years. You'll tell your kids, you should have been in eighth grade with me, man. So thank you, everyone. Just thank you.
We will now have our presentation of students and slideshow by our advisors, teachers Andrew, teachers Dan, and teacher Eric.
Jackson Parker Adams. This year has contained more than its share of challenging situations, and repeatedly, when you found yourself in these tough spots, you handled them with patience and grace. Whether it was the daily demands of pandemic learning or a difficult conversation, you gave your attention to those you were with. You spoke clearly and you rose to every occasion. Your courtesies you continually extended have made a real difference to those around you, especially this year. Thank you for your grace and compassion. Congratulations. Jordan Ashley Battle. For almost every question asked in our advisory this year, both silly and serious, you had a perspective to share with us. A perspective that was clear, strong, and each time taught us more about you and sometimes more about ourselves. Your inclination to share your thoughts and to ask questions freely is a powerful driver not only for your own learning, but for the learning of everyone around you. Thank you for asking the difficult questions and for wrestling with your feelings and thoughts. We are all better for it. Congratulations. Madeline Alex Cohen. When the going got tough throughout the year, you were always one of the first ones to jump in and get things moving. Your engagement in advisory, all of your classes, and JSU, and in your athletics show that you are someone who is actively looking for opportunities to contribute, not waiting to be asked. And if you ever went through tough times where the work felt heavy or you weren't enjoying yourself, you didn't show it. Never a groan, never a rolling of the eyes. You have been a superb leader throughout the year, showing us a way by your example. Thank you and congratulations. Dante DeChico, who is able to begin learning a new language with a group of students that had already studied it for a year and was able to catch up to his peers midway through the year during a pandemic? You were. This is no small feat, and it speaks volumes about you. You are interested, you work hard, you build knowledge, you work with others, and you care about your learning. Thank you for all of the grit and determination you brought to your learning throughout the year, and congratulations. Olivia Green, your interests are so interesting. Philosophy, the Korean language, illustration, all of these topics you more than dabble in. You immerse yourself in them and become a participant and contributor in their traditions. You have, at a very young age, seemed to internalize a lesson that will enrich your life and the lives of those around you. That something like philosophy is not for a select few, but for all those willing to think about it. Art is made by all those willing to take the time to make it. And there's no corner of interest too remote for you or anyone who is simply interested. Thank you for bringing your diverse interests into our lives, and congratulations. Paloma Herrera Puig. In your quiet, unassuming way, you put all of us at ease throughout the year. Woven into your easygoing and good-natured demeanor is a person of great character who feels strongly about right and wrong, is eager to work and help others when they need it, and is ready for higher level challenges. These traits are all the more powerful and effective due to the gentle manner in which you treat others and move about the world. As you said to all of us on Wednesday, you give your heart to others when you work with them. Thank you for all of your heart, and congratulations. Lila Milliken. Who am I going to ask all of my puppy questions to when you've moved on? You are our advisory animal expert, always eager to tell us more about animals, so that we might be more connected to how they feel, and perhaps then more connected to how we feel. And although your intelligence regarding animals is impressive, what sets it all in motion might be your incredible empathy. You care for people. Your care for people and animals is powerful, and coupled with your diligence and curiosity will be a true gift to every community you belong to. Thank you for all of the care you brought to our community, and congratulations. Claire Fadula, you came into a new school with all of its new teachers, new friends, new systems, new schedules, and you not only quietly rocked it as if you'd always been here, but you made our community substantially stronger. This is amazing. Your work for and contributions to all of your classes has been from the get-go, careful, thoughtful, thorough, and authentic. But you didn't confine yourself to the classroom. Your work on the sustainability committee and graduation committee was important to all of us. Thanks for all you brought to us this year, and congratulations. Elijah Pagan, your kindness, thoughtfulness, patience, and respect impressed me deeply this year. I saw it all year long in all sorts of circumstances. In our advisory discussions, in your interactions with your classmates and other teachers, in moments where the tedium of the school year were wearing us down, and in the moments when emotions and feelings could have easily been overwhelming. This world seems to be full of people who are eager to speak and be heard for the sake of being heard. Your patience leads you to think more before you speak, and that has made you a very respected person in this community, and it will in your future communities as well. Thank you and congratulations. Cole Semmel. This year has demanded more patience and endurance than is fair to ask of anyone, and you came to school every day, both virtual and in the classroom, ready to go. You were ready not only for your academics, though that's very impressive, and not only for your athletics, but your steady commitment carried you through the year. You were also ready to connect with others in a genuine and kind way every single day. Thank you for each and every small moment and the authentic connections you brought to every interaction. Thanks and congratulations. Ptolemy Stewart. When I think back on this year, one of my favorite memories will be watching skate videos with you and our advisory mates at lunch. Your rolling commentary, telling us about the skaters we were watching, as well as where they were in Philly and the places you were excited to skate someday, brought the city into our classroom. For some of us, our school life can feel all-consuming, especially when we're at school. Thank you for bringing us into a larger world. Congratulations.
I've been waiting all year to take my mask off, so now I can finally do it. Shelby Allen. Grit and calmness are traits that are hard to maintain, but you have kept both up during a year full of hurdles. Throughout this entire academic year, whether via Zoom or in the classroom, you demonstrated that a solid work ethic and having fun are actually some things that go together. One moment you're dancing in the morning advisory with other students, the next moment you are the most focused student in class. Thank you for being able to strike the right balance every day, and congratulations. Nora Colgan. What this century needs is humble and kind intellectuals with a solid moral compass. And you embody that ideal already as a middle schooler. Every day of this unusual academic year, you managed to enrich every classroom discussion by often saying the most profound things while always leaving space for others and for their other voices. Such maturity will serve you well in high school and beyond. Thank you for being an exemplary student, and congratulations. Olukayo de Ekundare. During all the months that you were an iSelect student, I already knew that you were a hard worker and a critical thinker with a great sense of humor. However, only when you joined my classes in person did I figure out that you're able to keep all those qualities while dancing in the classroom and doodling on the boards. You are able to combine, as the Romans said, what is dulce et utile, what is fun and what is useful. And you are an example for us all. Congratulations. Isaiah Marshall. Who would be able to join a new school in eighth grade, a community of students that already know each other, during a year of all kinds of restrictions and physical distancing, and still settle in smoothly? I can think of very few people to be able to do that, but you did exactly that. Your kind demeanor, your love of basketball, your talent for small talk, all make you an extremely valuable member of our community. Thank you for trying your best every day of the whole year, and congratulations. Sage Matunda. Very few students are able to remain as steady and calm as you, especially during this past year. You have shown at a young age that you are able to work independently and responsibly at home or in school. And in that regard, you are mature beyond your years. I'm convinced that you will have more and more fun, and you will thrive more and more as you'll be able to make more choices and specialize more in years to come. Be well, and congratulations. Dylan Parchman. Humor and critical thinking are perhaps the best ingredients of not only a fulfilling but also a productive life. And you have both in abundance. There truly has not been one advisory meeting or one Latin class that was not filled with your humor or without you challenging anything that I said. I am really grateful for that, even more than for the 3D printed sharpener in the shape of Caesar. Keep questioning the world around you, and you will become a truly critical citizen. You have all that it takes to make your high school experience a blast. Congratulations. Rachel Hannah Pastor. I cannot remember one early morning advisory meeting in which you were not more enthusiastic than any other person I've ever seen. You are lively and uplifting, and your presence in our group and classes makes everything nicer for everyone. Your love of music and your love of movies make every discussion more interesting. The fact that you have kept up this enthusiasm every day of the year during this entire year of pandemic instruction is an achievement that truly deserves a big applause. Congratulations. Daniel Wang. Staying the course is not easy for any middle school student or for any person in general, especially not during this academic year. The fact that you remained an iSelect student during the entire academic year, but also remained kind and engaged every day of every week, is an achievement that you should be proud of for years to come. Your countless math counts during our middle school gathering meetings are also an indication of persistence and dedication, and those will serve you well in years to come. Congratulations.
Almost there. Tibor Barankay. Tibor, I feel as if I have received a sports education simply by being in proximity of your frequent conversations demonstrating your extensive knowledge of multiple sports. I have always appreciated your kindness, your care for the inclusion of your classmates, your solid work ethic, and your talent as a writer. It always warmed my heart to see a fellow commuting cyclist as you entered each morning with your helmet strapped to your bag. Your recent comments in class, looking forward to spending time with your family in Germany, brought back a memory of your father riding with you to school a few years ago. I complimented him on his bike one day in the cafeteria long before I met you. I am confident your family is as proud of you as I am, and just as confident that you will do well in your next school. Congratulations. Hallie Ebley Schrader. Hallie, I feel as if you have just given us a peek of what you are capable of. Just as I peeked over your shoulder many times as you were buried in your sketchbook, only to find a brilliant composition underway and the work of an artist who was immensely talented, yet had no interest in receiving attention or accolades for that ability. I have always appreciated your strong sense of social justice and your ability to put forth strong work while being so soft-spoken. I'm excited and optimistic to see how the rest of the world reacts as you decide to share more of what you are capable of. Congratulations. Sam Goldwart. Sam, I am so appreciative to share your love of musical theater. I feel as if I have learned so much from you in our long conversations about music or politics at the end of the school day with someone who is clearly beyond their years, yet trapped in the body of a young person. I appreciate your strong sense of social justice, your embrace of your inner north, your role as an active voice, someone who is not afraid to take the lead in a group project, and someone who has demonstrated the remarkable maturity to be comfortable in their own skin. Congratulations. Catherine Alicia Gunther. Kate, I referred to you 2 years ago in a parent conference as a superstar. Someone who is apparently excellent at whatever they put their mind to, while simultaneously being humble, gracious, and helpful to everyone around them. That is even more true today. I appreciate your no-nonsense ability to get work done, to organize, to plan, and to lead with kindness. I appreciate your helping your classmates, your extreme politeness, your sense of social justice, and your ability to answer any question in great detail. I appreciate your strong sense of connection and pride in your immigrant ancestry. And as I found out that you have an interest in medicine, I cannot think of anyone whose hands I would be more comfortable in. Congratulations. Benjamin Alexander Kessler. Ben, it is remarkable how much you have grown as a student in the last few years. I remember during a parent conference a few years ago, your parents having every suggestion I could possibly have already thought out and put into action in a supportive and encouraging way. There wasn't much left for me to add, but to support you if needed. And I appreciate your strong work, your independence, your facility with technology, your artistic ability, and the humor and the quick-wittedness that you bring to the classroom every day. Congratulations. Emily Harper Kessler. Emily, sometimes the greatest maturity is to realize when it is time to move on. When it is time to carry with you your positive experiences and to be brave enough to have new ones. I so appreciate the humor and playfulness that you bring to the classroom every day. Your creative desk decorations, which I am clearly too old to make sense of. The depth of your friendships, and also your strong academic work. Your ability to advocate for yourself. And your willingness to take a whipped cream pie in the face for your Rube Goldberg project. I am very excited for you to follow your legacy. Westtown is lucky to have you. Congratulations. Daphne Aurora Close. Daphne, when I first met you early this year, I wasn't sure if you were making friends. I wasn't sure if you felt you were fitting in or enjoying the work. You are naturally quiet, shy, and reserved. But you showed great maturity in allowing things to evolve in their own time and in their own way. Your friendships blossomed, your schoolwork blossomed, and as the year went on, you became more and more indispensable to your friends and to the class. I appreciate your maturity, your solid work, your immense artistic talent, your ability to be a leading and active voice in group projects, and I am excited for your academic achievements in high school. Congratulations. Kylie Olivia Marut. Kylie, it's been such a pleasure being greeted by you every day with your infectious enthusiasm. Your anxiety and self-doubt is always more than balanced out by your exceptional work and attention to detail. I appreciate your considerable artistic ability and you bringing vibrant color and beauty to projects even when we don't expect it. I appreciate your enthusiasm for science and can't think of anybody who will make a better astrophysicist. I appreciate and will miss you wearing your heart on your sleeve and your ability to be so sweet, caring, and kind. Congratulations. Will Matry. Will, you are truly an older and more mature soul trapped in the body of a young person. I appreciate your strong, self-directed, and self-motivated work. I appreciate how helpful you are with all of your classmates, your genuine intellectual curiosity, your love of dinosaurs and paleontology, your professional approach to podcasting and all forms of audio recording, and your ability to raise questions that I had yet to consider. Congratulations. Oren Pipano. Oren, the world will be a better place with thinkers like you tackling our scientific problems. I so enjoyed your enthusiasm for science and math, as well as your finding and bringing to the classroom all of the latest scientific discoveries for discussions separate from whatever topic we were covering at the time. I appreciate your bold vision and ambition to create a really cool Rube Goldberg project and the amount of problem solving that you took on avidly. I appreciate your seeking reassurance in your work, even though I knew it would be excellent every time, and your understanding of the seriousness of the issues we discussed in the real world. Congratulations. Lena Gordon Piven. Lena, I first met you 2 years ago and was so impressed not only with your academic abilities, but your ability to be so self-assured and stylish at such a young age. The same is true today, but even more so. I appreciate you being such a warm and kind presence in the classroom, your ability to be silly and carefree at times, and such good friends to those around you. I appreciate your artistic ability and the splash of color that you bring to your desk, your posters, and your assignments. I appreciate your excellent planning ability to be such a serious group worker. Your positivity and kindness are infectious. Congratulations. Avery Rosen. Avery, I remember first meeting you when I held a graphic novel workshop 2 years ago and saw a picture of Iron Man that was way beyond your years in artistic skill level. As I have gotten to know you this year, I have come to find out that you are also a talented writer and a font of knowledge in baseball statistics. I enjoyed overhearing your sports debates with Ross and Tibor, the ones I was not qualified to participate in, but I learned a lot from, as you tossed the wiffle ball around the classroom. I appreciate your consistent hard work, your attention to detail, and your kind consideration of your classmates and group activities. I can't wait to see what you accomplished in high school. Congratulations. Oh, I'm sorry, yeah, thank you. Sorry, Ross, I didn't forget you. Ross Lee. Ross, you're exceptional in so many ways. You are so naturally bright, able to deconstruct any task put in front of you and figure out how to complete it successfully. It is always a pleasure to be greeted by you so warmly each day and to experience your genuine intellectual curiosity. I appreciate your being helpful to your classmates, your solid work, your love of sports, and your ability to argue your case vigorously with your friends. Penn Charter is lucky to have you. Congratulations. Gabriella Lau Sherman. Ella, I know I have said a lot of your classmates are kind, but you truly are one of the kindest people I know. Not only in your words and actions, but in your demeanor. You are a great friend to your classmates and always bring laughter and silliness to the room. You are also a consistently excellent student, always helping others when you can. And as your classmates emphatically recognized the other day, the definition of detail-oriented. I also appreciate your impressive visual art skills, your love of anime, and much of my own education about K-pop. I can't wait to see your successes in high school. Congratulations.
Please join me in celebrating our eighth graders one more time. Thank you, everyone. We will now watch a video. Oh, I'm sorry. My colleague, Chris Singler, would like to come and welcome our eighth graders to upper school.
Hi, everyone. I'm Chris Singler, upper school director here. It's so great to see so many familiar faces in the audience who already have children in the upper school. And for those of you who are moving on and not staying at Friends Select, I know you'll bring a little bit of Falcon pride with you to whatever school you go to. That's one of the things we do at Friends Select is we're preparing students to bring really good things to all of the communities they join, whether it's after eighth grade or after high school, and to make the world a better place. And I'm sure those of you moving on will do that. You also always have a home here, and I hope that you'll stop by and visit to either see a sporting event or a performance by your former classmates. For those of you moving on to upper school with us, I was just sitting here thinking, I must have been in this room 4 years ago when you were moving up from fourth grade into fifth grade. And that seems both like a short time ago and a long time ago. Pandemic has skewed my sense of time a little bit. But if you think about the growth that you went through in that time period from the age of 10 to 14, you'll go through similar growth from the ages of 14 to 18. Your classmates named, you'll probably be driving cars. You will definitely be able to vote at the end of those 4 years. But the great thing about high school is there's a lot of unknowns, and that might feel fearful right now, but it's really filled with possibility. Our community is going to be shaped in wonderful ways by whatever you bring to our high school. So we look forward to welcoming your gifts. Please speak up if you see something that could be better. And get ready to have fun. High school can be a lot of fun overall. Families, congratulations. And I just want to, before I end, a big shout out to Des Harmon, who did such a great job in the middle school.
Thank you, Chris. Thank you, everyone. We will now watch a video of our alma mater. I believe, Teacher Dan, this was put together last year. Since we weren't able to sing when we were planning, we're going to watch the video, and then I'll come back and we'll close out our ceremony. Thank you. Thank you, families. Thank you, students. You did it. Your year is over. Thank you so much for coming out today to celebrate with us. Again, we're so thrilled that we were able to, even though we're still in a pandemic, celebrate in person. Thank you for giving us your most precious gifts every day. We truly do take that seriously. We have some treats in the back. We would love for you all to share and enjoy, but have a wonderful day. Thank you.